Ireland's inhabitants have interacted with lakes for thousands of years. And lakes still provide enormous benefits for the people living in their catchments today. A dependable supply of drinking water, water to meet our agricultural needs, supporting local economies through tourism and for our own recreation. The link between human health, well-being and quality of environment has been clearly established, and these lakes and their wider landscape offer some of the wildest, most unspoiled natural capital to be found anywhere in Ireland. Ireland has been described as a land of lakes because of the number and unique variety of fresh waters dispersed across the island. Fáiltiúcadh, Fionn Lough Carra. Welcome to the Fair Lake of Carra, a magnificent marl lake situated in the plains of Mayo. Its pure waters draining through carboniferous limestone are surrounded by fringes of natural and semi-natural habitats, while supporting aquatic communities that have endured since they originally colonized these waters, as the last glaciers receded 10,000 years ago. The contrast between bedrock geology and rugged landscape, with the softness of its solution hollows and sediments, provides one of the most magnificent natural beauties in Ireland. And these famous, pellucid waters in ever-changing weather and light, seen once, leave a lasting impression. Alongside this great natural beauty, marl lakes have a particular significance given their rarity and the varied habitats and species that they sustain. Large cauliflowers of marl, formed as the dissolved limestone precipitates again, blankets the extensive shallows. Their calcareous deposits are made by primitive cyanobacteria, now known to be a critical part of a healthy marl lake. From the iconic angler's mayfly to the stronghold of the rarer yet less well-known indigenous beetle, its waters are highly productive and sustain fisheries of international renown. Its microscopic world is diverse, with a great number of planktonic forms, free-floating or motile, sustaining the higher trophic levels, each organism perfectly adapted to its environment, coexisting in some paradoxical way. Beneath the surface, an even more exotic world is found, hidden to most. Extensive clarified meadows in its shallow waters extend even deeper towards the lake's darker depths. This rich limestone lake in its prime was famous for its mayfly hatch, and for its large silver-flanked Carra trout that made many an angler's dream. Climate change and invasive species are just two of the threats that could potentially lead to the lake's demise. But further enrichment with nutrients lost from the land is the most significant problem. Disturbing a delicate natural balance that has existed for millennia. Opportunistic green algae proliferate now where excess nutrients reach the lake via nearby rivers and solution hollows. Their greedy blankets smother the marl and charophytes, which evolved to thrive in a naturally low nutrient environment. Forests of weedier plants have expanded their range, seen now in places for the first time in the lake's long history, and outcompeting species that are expected to thrive here. The starch-white sediments for which the lake is celebrated have lost their luster. But a new collaborative approach, a partnership of agencies, local communities and farmers, offers a new opportunity to conserve and restore this unique gem. In practice, we need to reduce nutrient loss wherever we can, to break its pathway before it reaches our groundwater, streams and lakes. Those wet fields, the shallow soils with karst features which have been carefully mapped, need a new approach to managing the leaky parts of the catchment which are the most prone to nutrient loss. People working together in their catchments can identify solutions based on scientific evidence and implement measures. This can work and will improve the situation. The unique gem that is Lough Carra needs to be conserved and protected for all our sakes, and allow it to continue to deliver its multiple benefits to our economy, our wildlife, and ourselves.